Are you ready to get your colorectal cancer screening test? Yet, you cannot choose between a stool-based at-home colon cancer test and a colonoscopy? Do you feel overwhelmed by the sheer number of tests available to you to check your colon for cancer? Having options is great, but having to choose the right one, it could be hard work. So in this video, I will help you make up your mind so you can get your test done and put your mind at ease. My name is Vera. I'm a passionate cancer prevention educator, a former marketer of anti-cancer medicines, and a mother of three. On this channel, Cancer Worry Free, you will find science-based updates without the science language in a bite-sized format. You will learn about best practices in early cancer screening, advances in cancer prevention, and health hacks to help you lower cancer risk for you and your loved ones.
Watch this video all the way through.
At its very end, I will share with you some simple things you can start doing today to begin lowering your risk for colorectal cancer. In 2017, three American organizations put their top experts together in what is called a US Multi-Society Taskforce for Colorectal Cancer. They reviewed all colorectal cancer screening tests from those done at home to those done in the clinic based on performance features, cost, and practical considerations. Then they divided them in three tiers. The tier 1 recommendations for people with an average risk for colorectal cancer are a colonoscopy every 10 years and a fecal immunochemical test, also known as FIT, every year. Let's talk about why this makes so much sense. It takes about 10 years for colorectal cancer to develop from a small precancerous polyp into a tumor. However, about 6% of the colorectal cancer diagnosis happen within the first 5 years from the last colonoscopy. So with these two tier 1 tests, the colonoscopy and the FIT, you get the best of the two worlds. You get a thorough review of your colon and rectum once every 10 years, and you get some reassurance of their condition every year in between your colonoscopies. My goal on this channel is to advocate for the best for you. So in this video, I will only review the top tier recommendations. If you would like me to review the lower tier recommendations as well, do let me know in the comment section below. Again, the top recommendation of the US Multi-Society Taskforce for Colorectal Cancer for people without high risks are to do colonoscopy once every 10 years and to do a home stool FIT test once a year. However, for those of you who want to choose between one and the other, I'm going to review and compare the two tests head to head on 6 different criteria. Before I dive into the comparison with you, I first want to review what is a colonoscopy and what is a fecal immunochemical home stool test. The colonoscopy is a visual test of the empty colon and rectum, a tube as thin as your finger with a light and a video monitor on it pass through your rectum and into your colon all the way through its end, all along sending images to a TV screen. The colonoscopy shows changes in the structure of the colon and the rectum.
It can remove polyps or other tissue for biopsy.
The fecal immunochemical test, FIT, checks for hidden blood from the lower intestines in the stool. Blood vessels in larger colorectal polyps or cancers are often fragile and easily damaged by the passage of stool. This test helps the lab detect the hard-to-see blood in the stool sample. Now let's compare the two tests, the colonoscopy and the FIT home stool test, to help you decide which one is the right for you, so you are no longer stuck in this limbo which way to go to get your screening done. The first criteria is effectiveness. With a single procedure, the colonoscopy can thoroughly review your colon and rectum detect structural changes, remove any visible polyps, which then become the biopsy for the lab. So basically, with one procedure, you get four outcomes. You get inspection, you get polyp removal, biopsy, and diagnosis. Based on the colonoscopy, the doctor can make a well-informed decision about the next steps. Would they be more frequent screening, less frequent screening, or a treatment plan? The fit home stool test, similar to the rest of the tests in this category, detects the hidden blood in the stool sample. That's it. So when the test detects hidden blood in the stool sample, the patient has to go to a colonoscopy to find out the reason and the source of it. So the scope of the fit home stool test is limited to raising a question without answering it. It can detect the possibility for colorectal cancer, but it cannot confirm it unless there is a colonoscopy as a follow-up. So which test wins the contest in effectiveness? It's clearly the colonoscopy. It does a very thorough job. It reviews your colon and rectum, removes the polyps, answers the questions, gets the job done, and you walk out of the doctor's office with a clear plan of action for your next screening or treatment.
Next criteria, accuracy.
If the colonoscopy scoops any polyps or tissue, they become the biopsy analyzed by the lab to confirm with certainty the presence or absence of colorectal cancer. In addition, the doctor can see the beginnings of a new polyp formation and give you a precise idea when your next checkup should be. The colonoscopy can miss some polyps, but they're usually very small and benign. On average, the FIT home stool test can detect around 80% of cancers. Yes, the FIT test does miss many polyps and some cancers. The test can detect the presence of blood, but it often confuses its source. For example, if there is an inflammation or a hemorrhoid that bleeds into the stool, the FIT test could give a false positive result that the patient has colorectal cancer. Lastly, the FIT home stool test is sensitive to temperature. So if the stool sample is being mailed in a hot weather, the sample quality would deteriorate before the sample reaches the lab and the results would be misleading. So which test wins the contest in accuracy? The undoubted winner is the colonoscopy. The colonoscopy is directly looking at the source of the bleeding. It doesn't have to guess. It can tell with certainty where the bleeding is coming from. It is not just looking at the polyps that bleed, but also at the polyps that don't bleed and could be precancerous. So if a colonoscopy results indicate that there is cancer or that there isn't cancer, these are results you can count on to be true. If so far you found this video useful, click the like button. If you want to continue staying on top of your cancer prevention game, consider subscribing to this channel for weekly updates. The next criteria is safety. Overall, the colonoscopy is a safe procedure, yet 15 out of 1,000 colonoscopies result in some harm to patients. If a polyp is removed during the colonoscopy, you might notice some bleeding in the next day or two after the procedure. Apart from bleeding, there could be tears in the colon, inflammation or infection of pouches in the colon, abdominal pain, problems in people with heart or blood vessel disease, and some reactions to the anesthesia. On the other side, the FIT home stool test does not cause any physical pain, discomfort, or bleeding. It may cause some psychological discomfort because it may raise concerns that later would turn out not to be valid. So which test wins the contest in safety? We have a clear winner again, but this time is the FIT home stool test. It causes no harm to the people during its use, except unless you sleep on the bathroom floor. So I do need you to watch your step. The next criteria is ease of use. The FIT home stool test can be done in the comfort of your home on your own time. After you see your primary care doctor, you don't need to schedule any other appointments. You don't need to change your routine, change your diet, change your lifestyle, or take time off from work. All you need to do is buy a FIT test from the nearby pharmacy, take a stool sample, put it in a ready-to-go container, and mail it back to a lab. On the other hand, the colonoscopy requires an extended time commitment and effort in the preparation on your part. You have to make an appointment or two with a GI specialist. Take at least the day of the procedure off from work. You need to change your diet starting 3 days before the procedure to exclude high fiber foods. The day before the procedure, you would stop eating any solid foods. You would be emptying your bowels with the help of a not-so-tasty laxative and making frequent trips to the bathroom. You will need to recruit a chaperone to drive you back and forth from the colonoscopy and to take notes after the procedure is over because you would be under the effect of the anesthesia. So you won't be able to drive and you won't be able to retain new information. The day after the procedure, you might experience some discomfort and fatigue.
Which test wins in ease of use? This time, the winner, without a shadow of a doubt, is the home stool FIT test. It takes little effort and time, does not require changes in your routine, and with a single trip to the bathroom, you get the job done.
The next criteria is infrequency. The recommended frequency for the colonoscopy for people without high risks is once every 10 years. So you get it done and you're all set for the next decade. People with a higher risk may have to repeat it more frequently. For example, people with a history of inflammatory bowel disease may have to do it as frequently as 1 to 2 years. On the other hand, the FIT home stool test needs to be done every year. So you need to keep track of the time since the last test and make sure that you remember to do it annually at about the same time. Data shows that after 2 to 3 yearly tests, if the results are negative, people become complacent about taking the annual test. So there is less commitment to the FIT home stool test as years go by. And of course, we know that there is no benefit to a test if it doesn't get done. So which test is less frequent? Clearly, the colonoscopy is a lot less frequent than the FIT home stool test is, especially for people without high risk factors for colorectal cancer. The last criteria in the comparison is no follow-up required. When you do your colonoscopy, at the very same appointment, you can learn your diagnosis and your recommended screening schedule moving forward. If not at the same appointment, maybe within the same week. If the FIT test determines that there is a possibility for colorectal cancer, you would have to undergo a colonoscopy anyway to confirm the diagnosis. Also, if the sample deteriorated in a hot weather climate, you may have to redo your FIT test in a cold weather week to make sure that it reaches the lab in a good condition. So, which test does not require follow-up to confirm the validity of its findings? It is clear that the colonoscopy is superior to the FIT home stool test because it is complete, exhaustive, and conclusive. You will not have to do another test to validate the colonoscopy findings. They are just enough to help your doctor make a well-informed recommendation for your screening, prevention, and treatment. To summarize, the most recent recommendation of the US Multi-Society Taskforce for Colorectal Cancer for people without high-risk factors is to do the colonoscopy once every 10 years and to do the FIT home stool test once every year. If you want to choose between one or the other, you can choose them based on what matters more to you. If ease of use, convenience, and safety matter more to you, then the FIT test would be the best option. If you want to put in the extra effort and time in the preparation for a colonoscopy, then you would reap the benefits of a test which is more effective, more accurate, more conclusive, and requires no further validation. It all depends on what you value most. In the end of the day, the best test is the test that gets done. Early screening is worthwhile. It adds years to your lifetime and gives you peace of mind. There is a new category of tests emerging and getting established at this time. This is the category of blood cancer tests, also known as liquid biopsy tests. I will have a separate video on this topic, so click the notification bell to make sure you don't miss it. In the beginning of the video, I promised those of you who watched this video all through its end to learn some simple things you can do to start lowering your risk of developing colorectal cancer. Here are five behavioral factors in order of importance that are proven to increase your colorectal cancer risk. Alcohol consumption starting at 30 grams or 2 drinks per day, obesity with a body mass index of 30 or more kilograms per square meter, red meat consumption of 100 grams or more per day. Red meat includes beef, pork, lamb, and goat. Processed meat consumption of 50 grams per day or more. Any meat that is prepared by curing, smoking, salting, or adding chemical preservatives is considered processed meat. And last but not least, smoking. People who smoked even for a short while have an increased risk over the ones who never smoked. Now that you know the five factors in your behavior that contribute to your colorectal cancer risk, you know what to do about them. If you cannot quit cold turkey, you will already make progress if you consume less alcohol, consume less red and processed meats, smoke fewer cigarettes. There is one thing you should do more of, and this is being active and being on the go. You don't need to join a gym. It is enough if you just start walking more, running more errands, doing more gardening or home improvement projects. Everything that gets you going and moving is contributing to you lowering your risk for colorectal cancer. If you found this video helpful, consider subscribing to my channel. If you like the content, click the like button, comment below, and share the link with your friends. I will see you in the next video. Until then, get your screening test done, worry less, and live more.